called me on Tuesday night, asked me if I was sheriff. I knew when I saw my number pop up on my phone, I was like, oh, should I answer? I know she will ask me to do something. But nonetheless, you know, you gotta be always ready, yeah?
Amen.
So I prayed after she called me, I prayed the day after and the day after, and nothing came until yesterday. And I mean, all of these ideas are coming, it's just, I already talked about my dad many times, at least twice I talked about him. So we're gonna talk about him again today. Because he has, well, I have many stories from him growing up, like Mama Kaku. They, Hawaiian men, I don't know if they really know how to show love, you know? But let's just pause there, fathers. Good fathers are made, not born. But to be a good father, you need a model, an example of a father that you can pattern yourself after. Where do you find such a father? Where do you look? Is there such a thing as a perfect father? Yes, there is. And today, let's see what we can learn through my personal experiences about being a father by looking to God, the perfect father. Amen?
Amen.
God loves his children. One story I remember about my dad growing up is when it's time for God, it's time for God. Right? You never say no. All family gatherings, he asked me to pray. Because out of all of my cousins and everybody in the family, we were the only ones that was going to church at the time. So he looks at us and we're holding hands, pray. No. I don't know what kind of spirit came over me that day, but for me to tell my dad no, that was cracks, yeah. Many of us can associate with me because our upbringing was about the same. So can you imagine, we're standing there holding hands, getting ready to pray. Everybody, when you pray, your eyes are supposed to be closed, your head's supposed to be down, right? My dad was like this. Okay. As soon as my sister ended up praying that time, as soon as she said amen, whack! Slap across my head, kick the Bible falling all over the lanai. Proverbs 22:6 says, train up a child in the way he should go. And when he is old, he will not depart from it. My dad's love was a different kind of love. He taught us to cling close to God and keep our eyes on him. Thank you, Dad, for pounding God's word into us. Unlike my dad, God loved us and loved us first. He didn't wait for us to meet his expectations or wait for us to make him proud. He didn't wait until we measured up to his standards. He loved us completely, constantly, and unconditionally. Amen. It may anger him when we disobey, sadden him when we go astray, but he never stops loving us. Amen.
Amen.
God loves his children, and so should we. Amen, Dad? God encourages his children. Not about picking on my dad. And talk about me. Back in February, my son, Buddy, was chosen to represent Tekula Olehumi Kaibonino at the Lakutahekahe Olelo competition on Oahu. With just 1 week to learn and memorize a new chant, I worked hard every day, practice again. Come home from school, practice, practice, practice. It was red. It was makaukau. Okay. Flew up. I had to ask families on Facebook for money to pay for my trip because the school wouldn't pay for the parents, but they would pay for the child, which is understandable. So families gave money. Thank you, Anna and Tilani. They gave money so that I could be up there with them. We got up there up to, I want to say, 20 minutes before he went on the stage. He had it down. Motions, everything, you know. Leo Dui, everything. It was his turn. He was the last of 13 kids, I believe, in his age bracket. And I could already tell something changed in him. He was nervous. He looked like he was going to cry. But he still went, persevered, he went through the whole chant, finished it up. Not like how we practiced it. The whole time I'm recording him, going Facebook Live so that everybody who's not there can see how he's doing, I'm like... I was so mad. I never talked to him the whole flight home. Terrible, yeah. But he talked to me and I'm like... We got to back to Kona, got in the car, ripped home. I told him, I ain't never gonna help you again. You ain't never gonna enter a competition again. You waste my damn time. So stupid. Apostle Paul challenges us, do not let any unwholesome talk come out of your mouth. To myself, but only what is helpful for building others according to their needs, that it may benefit those who listen. Ephesians 4:29. Sadly, many parents, myself included, are quick to put their children down and criticize them rather than lift them up with encouragement. God, on the other hand, saw the things his children could do and encouraged them to go and do them. Buddy, I love you, yeah? You know that, yeah? I'm sorry. The last point I want to tell you guys about God is he disciplines his children. Now it's summertime, normal school, kids are home. Daddy's a stay-at-home mommy now. So I'm constantly, 24/7, yelling at my kids, slapping them. They just don't listen. If they're fighting, I let them go. As soon as I hear one of them crying, then I get involved. My method of parenting is whoever was involved in the scrap at the time won't get slapped. I'm not going to see all the time who causes it, right? You know what I mean? So all of them. Whether they cause them or not, they'll get slapped. I'm always telling my kids, you guys like late things, yeah? You guys not learn yet? Guess not. For it says in Hebrews 12:10-11, our fathers disciplined us for a little while as they thought best. But God disciplined us for our good, that we may share in his holiness. No discipline seems pleasant at the time, but painful. Later on, however, it produces a harvest of righteousness and peace for those who have been trained by it. Church, it is our responsibility to bring our children up in the training and instruction of the Lord. Amen?
Amen.
I want my kids to be good citizens in this world. And the only way I know how is to keep them grounded in God's word. This concludes my message. I just thank God for the many blessings. Even though my kids drive me nuts, I thank God for my kids. Because he can just take them away just like that. You know what I mean? He can take away everything you get. So I just thank God for his many blessings. And I never sing this song a long time, but I've been singing today. And I just pray that at least one of you guys learn from my experiences and take heed into your heart of what God spoke through me to you guys today. So I want to mahalo this, my brother over here. I've been blessed with so many
all of a sudden he's in church, and now he's a cop all the time, you know? I like that, yeah. And like all of us sharing, you all want the best for our kids, you know? Proverbs says everything, how to raise your child, the way he should go, you know?